as you've probably heard, Donald Trump still refuses to release his tax returns. One reason he might be doing that is so we can't actually confirm how much money he's given to charity. And now a new report suggests that the donations that come from Trump's personal foundation are almost entirely other people's money. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. In general, Trump's aversion to paying people like contractors and employees who did work for businesses has hurt him. Even now, on the campaign trail, it causes him problems. For example, you may remember this dance troupe of young girls called the USA Freedom Kids who performed at a Trump rally earlier this year.
Cowardice. Are you serious? Apologies for freedom. I can't handle this.
President Donald Trump knows how to make America great. Deal from strength or get crushed every time.
That song sounds like it was translated from English to Japanese and then back to English. Big man, White House. Dolphin hat, pineapple, little mouse. Well, you'll never guess what happened next. Donald Trump stiffed the USA Freedom Kids.
The USA Freedom Kids are calling on Trump to pay them. Their manager, father of one of the girls, says the Trump campaign broke agreements with them, refusing to let them sell CDs at a rally, then canceling their performance in Iowa after they'd already traveled there.
Now, the USA Freedom Kids, those little girls, they're now suing Donald Trump.
Trump is being sued by a group of children because he won't pay them. Think of how sad that is. Right now, the USA Freedom Kids are at home trying to find words that rhyme with subpoena. Then again, in Trump's defense, look what happens when he does give money to kids. Ugh. And it isn't just the USA Freedom Kids. Trump also used to have a policy office in D.C. Now, most normal presidential candidates have policy offices where staffers work on ideas to fill out a candidate's platform. But Trump's policy office quickly fell apart, once again, because he stiffed people.
The Washington Post reports tonight that the Trump campaign's policy staff has collapsed. One of the people who quit told the Washington Post, quote, "It's a complete disaster. They use and abuse people. The policy office fell apart in August when the promised checks weren't delivered."
Campaign spokesman Jason Miller acknowledged the Washington policy office grew smaller in August, but he called the effort a success.
Oh, yeah, I mean, it definitely was a success. I mean, just look at the extremely in-depth policy plan the Trump team came up with to fix Obamacare.
Repeal and replace with something terrific.
Something terrific? That's not a policy. That's a Frank Sinatra B-side. Did they at least come up with a detailed policy plan for fighting ISIS?
I would bomb the out of them.
Okay, that's... So obviously, Trump did not care that his policy office fell apart. In fact, Trump has been so resistant to having actual policies that, by his own telling, it took repeated badgering from his daughter Ivanka to get him to unveil a new maternity leave policy yesterday.
I'm going to roll out a plan to help our mothers and our families get affordable, quality child care for their children. And my daughter Ivanka is going to be involved. She is the one that has been pushing for it so hard. Daddy, Daddy, we have to do this, and it's true.
Just to be clear, I don't care about women. She does. Okay?
Also, she's a successful businesswoman and a mother of three. You make her sound like Veruca Salt. Daddy, I want paid maternity leave, and I want it now. Do it, Daddy. Do it. So Trump's unwillingness to pay people has resulted in lawsuits and a lack of policy. Now, that might give Trump a reputation as something of a miser, but at least there's all the money he's given to charity, right? He and his campaign have bragged about that so many times.
Anyone who knows about Donald Trump and his career knows that this is a man who's given away tens of millions of dollars to charitable causes.
I know Donald Trump has donated over $100 million to charitable causes over the last number of years.
Number one, I am a nice person. I give a lot of money away to charities and other things.
But without proof in the form of tax returns, reporters have had to check for themselves to find Trump's personal donations. One reporter in particular, David Farenthold of The Washington Post, has been trying for months to track down Trump's charitable giving, and he's come up almost completely empty.
So far, I've called 326 charities that seem to be closely tied to Donald Trump, looking for evidence that they had gotten money from Trump. And between 2008 and this May, I found just one donation out of Trump's own pocket. That was in 2009, and it was for less than $10,000.
So his campaign claims 100 million, but reporters can only find 10,000. That's like saying you have a private jet when you only have a private Jetta. So that's Trump's personal giving. And then there's the Donald J. Trump Foundation. The foundation has Trump's name on it, so you'd think it consists at least in part of Trump's own money. But not only has Trump not given to his own foundation in years, the foundation has actually charged charities for using Trump facilities.
Donald Trump hasn't given any of his own money to the foundation that bears his name since his last donation in 2008. In many cases, if not all the recent ones, he takes the money that's been donated to his own foundation, puts his name on it, and gives it to other people. For 2 years, the Trump Foundation gave liberally to the Palm Beach Police Foundation. The group holds its policeman's ball at Trump's Mar-a-Lago resort every winter. But get this, Wolf, Trump's Mar-a-Lago actually charged the police foundation for using the ballroom. Not a small amount either. The foundation's tax records show that it paid Trump more than $500,000 over the course of 2 years for two of the balls it held there.
When has anybody ever been paid $500,000 just for holding two balls? Oh, come on, guys. No. Shame. And on top of that, Trump also apparently used some of the money in his foundation to buy things for himself, including, in one instance, according to the Washington Post, Trump spent $20,000 of money earmarked for charitable purposes to buy a 6-foot-tall painting of himself. Now, so far, no one's been able to find that painting, but that's not the craziest part of the story. The craziest part is that Trump already had another giant painting of himself. Who needs two giant paintings of themselves? When I check into a hotel, I feel bad asking for two key cards. The painting even caught the attention of President Obama, who mentioned it while campaigning for Hillary Clinton on Tuesday.
One candidate's family foundation has saved countless lives around the world. The other candidate's foundation took money other people gave to his charity and then bought a 6-foot-tall painting of himself. I mean, he had the taste not to go for the 10-foot version, but.
Man, am I gonna miss stand-up comedy Obama. It's only a matter of time before he starts doing campaign events in front of a brick wall. You all see this Trump painting? You know, the eyes follow you wherever you go. Unless you go into a black neighborhood. What else? You know, I think Trump has a reverse picture of Dorian Gray's situation going on. Trump looks like but the painting stays young forever. What else? Anybody here got a wife? Make you eat healthy? And that wasn't the only bizarre purchase Trump made with his foundation's money, because according to the Washington Post, Trump used money donated for charity to buy himself a Tim Tebow signed football helmet. And for everybody who thinks Trump's gonna turn the economy around because he's a brilliant businessman, he spent money on a helmet signed by Tim Tebow, who is currently playing a different sport.
I also own a framed Michael Jordan jersey.
So to recap, Trump won't give money to children who perform at his rallies or staffers who work on his policy proposals, but he will use other people's money to buy signed football helmets and a giant painting of himself, and he still could be our next president. As the USA Freedom Kids put it,
I can't handle this.
This has been a closer look.